What does anger feel like in your body? That may be sort of the most important question that I ask people is, and I say, no one's ever asked you what you feel in your body before. That's going to be very strange. We're together, we're going to learn a language mm-hmm. where we can begin to put left brain language on a right brain experience. And the brain likes that. It helps it calm down, kind of integrate it. So always, what's happening? What does it feel like? Can we put some sensation words on it? And always in AEDP, we're doing this meta-processing. So we're having an experience, and then we are processing what it's like to have an experience. So it's one thing to have an experience, but especially if it's good, mm-hmm. you have to know that you've had this good experience. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it's just another layer of healing and a reference point to come back to. For the particular person to remember, oh, I was connected at least on Tuesday, and I knew I was connected, and Hillary knew I was connected, and it was real. Mm-hmm. There's power in that.
Very.
Yes,
very
yes,
much,
yes.
Very much.
Yeah.
And if we are in the couple together, yeah. at what point do you try to have the partners do this for each other? Mm. How central are you? And they do, and this is all happening with you
yes.
versus you're trying to have this happen between them.
Yes. Well, most of the time when they're ready, couples, I have them turn towards each other. I want them, as they're sharing something that's important, right, that they have been mm-hmm. wanting to be heard, that they want their partner and that the partner has not been able to hear. Mm-hmm. I say, I want to go very slowly. I want you to share what you want your partner to know. And I want you to notice him as or her as you're sharing it. Mm-hmm. Because I want the person to notice, am I speaking so fast that the person, again, starts to dissociate or move away? Is the person feeling insulted? To read the nonverbal cues is so helpful. With my own husband, I can't imagine. You know, when we are in a squabble and we start to, you know, you're doing okay and then all of a sudden you're off the rails, right? And you're in a fight and you're triggered. And if once you notice the tone of voice, the turning away, you know, if it's some people walking out of the room, the rolling eyes, the huffing and the puffing, then you're like, okay, let's stop. Can we rewind? Where did we go wrong? And it's usually a miscommunication most of the time, I find, you know, with couples who truly love each other and they want to work it out. They heard somebody said, you know, can you take out the garbage? And the other person heard, you never do anything around the house to help, as you know. So then we can go back to that moment and each person can say what they meant and mm-hmm. what they heard and what the intent was. And a repair can be made that usually, because it's we understand it every which way, when it happens again, they're like, oh, we've been here before, and now we can stop and do it ourselves. Because mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I think that's the idea, that couples can then become their own therapists for each other in a way.
Yeah. Right. The book is chock full with exercises. Give me one or two that's...
Well, of course, throughout the book, we're it starts with learning to slow down. Mm-hmm. Very, very important. That's in the beginning, and I take you through how to work this triangle. So we're learning to notice what emotions we have. We're learning to, I guess I like what I wrote about, learning to identify the things that cause us shame, because I do think that that is the secret to so much healing, that once we are aware of the things that we feel bad about, and we can start to get curious about how did we learn to feel bad, let's say, about not being a great student. And we know, because it's all over the culture, you know, the messages. But I have people write down the messages, all the shoulds that they heard, how they should be, how they should feel, what they should do, what they should want, what they shouldn't want. And I also like the exercise I wrote about working with guilt, because there's the kind of guilt where you really didn't do anything wrong, like when people feel guilty just for having a feeling or for just evoking a feeling in somebody else. And then there's guilt for real transgressions where you have to make amends and you have to apologize, and distinguishing between those two things. Mm-hmm.